My name is Marian, and I'm here to show you how to scale your app with Facebook ads. So before starting, a few words about myself. So I've been holding several leadership positions in growth marketing for 5 years, focusing on CRM, SEM, and in the last 3 years on mobile marketing and Facebook advertising. And what I would like to show you today is what's the opportunity with Facebook ads and how HelloFresh is leveraging them to scale massively, and share with you a few innovations and actions you can implement to scale as well. First, opportunity. So a few striking statistics. So first, according to Comscore in the US, more than half of the smartphone users don't download any new app in a month. So that's what we call app fatigue. And getting into people's smartphone is like a real estate investment. So the striking fact as well is that the time that is actually spent by the smartphone user is spent only in their favorite apps. So actually, a user spends half of its time in his favorite app and 3/4 of its time on his 3 favorite apps. And guess which apps are those lucky ones? So Facebook is actually the most used apps, and Facebook owns 3 of the top 6 apps. So basically, Facebook has an incredible reach, and because it's key for any retailer or app growth marketer to be relevant and to be where the user actually is and spends time, you need to leverage Facebook to grow your app. That's what HelloFresh has been doing. So I would like to give you a little bit more background about HelloFresh. So first, who of you already know the business model? Okay, quite a few, about half. So let me explain very quick then. So the magic of the model is that it's subscription-based. So it all starts with the consumer subscribing in the app or in web, and then you get weekly a food box with portioned ingredients for 3 to 5 meals, and then you make magic happen in the kitchen based on the recipes that you chose. So subscription-based business model you can manage in your app or also on the website. And basically, we've been massively successful. So we launched 6 years ago, and this year we just went IPO 4 weeks ago, and we are most likely going to cross the 1 billion euro revenue thresholds. Our app downloads also massively scaling, with forecasted about 3 million downloads this year. And all this, we are actually aiming to be profitable very soon, with our losses just about 7%. So it's, of course, it's thanks to a strong operational margin, but you can imagine when you see this scale, how the growth marketing setup has been crucial to bring HelloFresh to that level, so in terms of scale and in terms of efficiency. And Facebook ads is a huge area of focus for HelloFresh. So the investment is double digit in terms of share of the total budget, and very comfortably in the double digit. So in this timeline, so the first graph, it's basically in the last 5 quarters. So I joined in Q3 2016, and you can see that we increased the spend quarter over quarter as we saw success and scale. Of course, our approach to Facebook growth is holistic. So we look not only at new subscribers, but also CAC and lifetime value to generate revenues in the long term. That's what you see in the second graph. So basically, we tripled the amount of new users subscribing every month. At the same time, cost of customer acquisition and lifetime value increased in the same range of 15 to 20%. And then you can see the scale of the downloads coming from Facebook as well, multiplied by 3 in a year. So to make this happen, I'd like to share with you 5 ingredients for success that you can implement and that are really at the core of our success. First ingredient, so at HelloFresh, we have identified as a key pillar and key priority to invest in a high-quality creative pipeline. So what we mean with high quality doesn't have to be extremely expensive, professional-looking pictures. It can sometimes be like amateur style that are performing best. But what I mean is that having really thoughtful concepts that are based on your unique selling proposition that differentiates you from your competitor, and all of this nicely executed. So at HelloFresh, we have an in-house team with three FTEs in doing design, fully prioritized on Facebook. So you have several ways to do it. That's what we chose. And so we build, we put a lot of effort into building this pipeline. And okay, so now that you have clarified the resource you want to invest, how should you guide this pipeline? So you need to make sure to provide a lot of new elements and at the same time not rocking the boat of performance. So why new elements? Because at the end, Facebook is a content eating machine. So if you want to keep scaling, you need to show new things to ever saturating audiences. So what we have defined as a testing plan is for each audience, we have no more than 3 or 4 ads, so we can have like significant results. And we have a mix of proven winners and new concepts to test. So a proven winner is a concept that has been already tested, that we know is performing super well. So I can give you an example here. It's a video that shows our box and ingredients stacking up in it. So super transparent, super honest, amazing conversion rate, driving a lot of sales with it. So you have to have one proven winner in each audience to make sure the performance is stable. Then you need to build variations to your proven winner. So in this example, you see clearly the background color, the main difference. Why variations? Because you need to isolate variables and then A/B test those variables to identify learnings. So for instance, it could be as well ingredients, what performs best between Asian dishes, burger, avocado, or eggs. And that way you generate structural learnings. Then you need to build, of course, new concepts. In this case, the new concept we tested is based on the fact that HelloFresh is taking the stress out of dinner by facilitating the weekly dinner planning, so you don't need to think what you're going to cook next. So we associate like the weekdays with the specific dishes in the creative. So that's how it looks like, and super top performing. And once you have a new proven winner, you just add it back to your pipeline of proven winners and start building variations. And most and last important part of the creative pipeline, new formats. So Facebook is constantly creating new formats. For instance, Instagram stories, photo albums, collection ads for web. And it's super important to be present, to enjoy cheap cost per impressions and a competitive advantage. So here is an example of what we developed for Instagram stories. And the key with a new format is to really develop designs natively for them. So don't recycle a creative that performs well on the newsfeed to Instagram stories, for instance, but think really of the context in which users are enjoying the content, what comes before, what comes after, and design the full concept just for that. So in this case, it's a lot of emojis and text overlays and a good rhythm with sound and a sticky screen at the end to let the time of the user to see the CTA. So yeah, creative, huge focus for us. Then the second ingredient is of course audiences. So at the end, Facebook is creative on audiences and with bidding on top. So the key for us to scale was to reduce our dependency on lookalike audiences. So of course, don't get me wrong, lookalike audiences is clearly the best performing one. It's the baseline of our prospecting campaigns. But if you want to scale, you need to get incremental reach by targeting new audiences. So we do it in a clear three-step process. So first, identify your persona, so downloader persona or buyer persona. So in our case, okay, three examples. You have Amanda, highly educated, high income. You have Steve, advanced e-commerce shopper. Amy, healthy living enthusiast. And for each persona, step two is to find, brainstorm how you can reach this persona with the Facebook core targeting. So in this example of Amanda, who's a highly educated, high income, you can think of interest targeting. She must be a knowledge hunter, so target language learning apps, high quality blogs, maybe horse riding for expensive hobby or classical music. Then think maybe of education, master degree, doctorate degree, or maybe the top universities of the country. You can think of partner categories, which is this offline data that feeds the Facebook targeting and target directly all the upper income options. So that enables you to reach like less obvious audiences and targeting. And then in the third step, so make your testing plan. Important is to test the audiences for some time. Don't let it at least 1 or 2 weeks to let the algorithm find the right people. And eventually, always look back at the lifetime value of the audiences, because it's completely fair to buy an audience that will have a lower lifetime value as long as your cost of customer acquisition is lower as well, and vice versa. You might want to pay higher to make sure to reach the high quality users. So that's in some countries, we reach up to 30% incremental sales and downloads with this technique. Then the next ingredient is basically to, if your KPI is sales or download, think of more funnels starting on Facebook where you can reach those KPIs. So for instance, our product is a new, complex and disruptive, so sometimes it requires a little bit of explanation to convince people to download the app and buy. So we found that we have amazing call centers, like calling people and selling them the box. So we said, okay, why not combine both? And then we had lead generation campaigns on Facebook that we would send automatically to the call centers to who would close the deal. So you can do that, and the call center can be trained to make your user download the app. And that's, yeah, we reach massive scale with this. You can see as well, A-B test, A versus web campaigns, or for instance, add micro conversions to your funnel. So if the person is not completing the sales, maybe you can get the phone number to then have the call center call the person and download the app or close the sales. And the underlying principle behind it, so why it helps you scale, is first because different campaign objectives on Facebook are gonna help you reach new users. So Facebook knows who's likely to download an app. Facebook knows who's likely to give their information and make a lead. So then more campaign objectives, more reach. And then keep in mind as well that you may have different strategy working with different audiences. So the ideal case is if you can A-B test different strategies on the same audience and then find the right strategy for each targeting. Next, very important ingredient in our recipe of success is automation. So we invest a lot of resources in automation. So the reason is clear that at the end, if you have one person in your team completing a task 10 minutes per day, at the end of the year is a full week that is gone. So what you want is to reduce to the maximum the amount of time spent in reporting or optimization so that everyone can focus on more strategic topics, for instance, manage the channels, think holistically of the setup and have a consistency across channel, or like really innovate and bring, for instance, new advertising concept to the table. So very, very important. And if you need to adjust the organization of your team for it or change what skills you're looking for when you hire, just think of it, and automation should be at the core of your strategy. So a few examples for us. So of course, you can use all the data from your MMP, from Facebook. We actually use Tableau, which is amazing to merge different data sources and have in one view, just when you hit a refresh button, like all the KPIs that matter for you. Then, okay, we use CrossEngage as a CRM tool, so we automatically push all the audiences to Facebook, so no manual upload of files. And also we use Facebook order ID, so basically we give to Facebook our unique order ID when the sales happen via Facebook in the app, and then we can use it to understand the purchasing journey as well as the lifetime value. So more insights, more time to think strategically. The automation is extremely crucial. And then the last ingredient I want to share with you today is attribution. So you need to approach it in an iterative manner. So don't wait for the bing bang. You're never going to get the exact truth of the exact value that each channel brings at a given point. So what you need to do is just be hacky and iterative, and then just add more insights, more sources of data to be closer to the truth, like step by step in this journey. And then some tools available, for instance, so of course you have all the Facebook data, post-click, post-view with the different time windows, use your MMP data. We also use voucher use because we give discounts for some channels, especially offline. We have as well a checkout survey that was a massive game changer for us. So simply asking to the user, where did you hear of our app? Where did you hear of HelloFresh for the first time? And then we saw like massive insights looking at that, so the RDRD again. Then you have some tools starting to develop using machine learning, so those multi-touch attribution model, which are statistical models that tries to understand the incremental value of each channel. And then you have the Facebook conversion lift studies, where let's say 10% of your users don't see any ad for some time, and then you're able to calculate the incremental value. So how many app downloads happened anyway, and how many app downloads happened just because of Facebook. Yeah, that's and then beta attribution, of course, you optimize for ROI and you allocate the budget where you are most likely to be able to scale. So now you have the five most important ingredients. So that's basically how we made of Facebook a really key channel for our growth and our app growth. So thank you. If you want to discuss this a little bit further, you can find me at the break or at lunchtime, or just contact me on LinkedIn. And we are constantly growing the team, so we are hiring as well for a few profiles, including senior innovative paid social managers. So if you feel like it's a challenge, you can just check on, just go and talk to me. Thanks a lot.